keep it going for Nathan there. You guys doing okay?
Yep.
So, I was born in Czechoslovakia, but I don't have an accent, right? Which kind of sucks, that sometimes I wish I did have an accent. But not necessarily a Czech accent, because they always sound like they're bitching about something. I'd want something a little more cooler. Maybe Australian or British, right? Because it seems like these guys can say something, no matter what, it still sounds pretty good. They can say something dumb as fuck, and it still sounds okay. So for example, Brick can say, I apologize for the faint odor that went on the seat to my bones. It doesn't sound all that bad, does it? In fact, you feel some compassion for the poor guy, right, in his dilemma? But I mean, let's see, an Australian, I mean, he could, let's see, an American tried that, right? If he did, it would kind of come out like this. Dude, shit, not the same impact, is it? No. And I mean, the Aussies and the Brits, they can say things that we can't say here. I mean, over in the UK and Australia, they can throw around words that we can't. Like, for example, the C word, right? They can use that, they can throw it around all day and night, any time, any day, any situation. Like, for example, an Australian can come over and take a look at the new baby. He's a charming little cunt. Doesn't sound too bad, does it? But if an American tried that, the mom actually would be offended, and they'd probably kick his ass so much that he would shit himself. But with the Aussie saying it, it actually makes your newborn or your new family member sound that much more adorable. So how about, guys, let's give this a try tonight. When you're in bed with your special loved one or whoever else you pick up tonight, just kind of lean into her, rub her shoulder, gaze into her eyes. It's a boy, you're a sexy kind angel. And see how far you get. And if she doesn't mind, let me know if she has a sister. And speaking of changing voices, gentlemen, your voice will change twice in your lifetime. Okay, so first, puberty. And then second time, about 6 months after your baby. Yeah? Oh, don't laugh, ladies. Yours changes too. So, you'll notice that a man's voice, after about 6 months of marriage, all of a sudden he starts sounding like Goofy or Bullwinkle, with the dexterity of Barney the dinosaur. And then women, after about 6 months of marriage, they start to sound like Roseanne Barr or George Costanza's mother. So, and this comes in handy when they're explaining to their friends what the spouse did wrong. So all of a sudden the guy starts sounding like, oh, I don't know, I'm sorry, I didn't know I didn't have the children. And then the women start sounding like, what are you doing in there? How long are you going to be? And I wonder if this is true for the Bachelor contestants. Like, after 6 months, you know, they're all nice and good-looking on TV, and they sound great, and they're in love. And after 6 months, do they start sounding like that? Oh, I like this. This is nice. Thanks for the rose, asshole. Now, there are two types of couples that this phenomenon doesn't affect. So first off, Asian couples. I have yet to see an Asian, a dumb Asian. Bad driver, yes. But they're still smart because they know they made a mistake as soon as they did it. Because you ever notice when you're driving by, they're like,
sorry.
But then you've got, and then the other couple is gay men. Because they have nothing to be mad about. They're always happy. They've got double the wardrobe. They've got all the shows on TV that they both like. And then to boot, they've got a plethora of parades every year to celebrate just how fucking happy they are. So anybody have any anniversary or anything? Any anniversaries? No? I'm actually celebrating an anniversary. It's It's my one day masturbating anniversary. And I celebrate every day. I mean, back when I was younger, I used to celebrate the 6-hour anniversary. Never got anything done, but I mean, back in my 20s, I entered a masturbating competition. I finished first, and fifth, and 12th. And in other news, a few months back, I got a vasectomy. And I hated that the doctor knows you all too well. Because just before I left, he put a surgical cone around my head. Oh, wait, that was so good. But apparently he thought back to my previous surgery about having a couple ribs removed. So I wrote a study about sexual activity amongst conjoined twins. Do you know that they have a very high rate of threesomes? So the other day I'm driving down the highway behind one of these trucks that's got the hay bales on it, with a bit of snow on top, and this shit's just fucking flying out right all over the windshield. I'm getting pissed off and I'm like thinking, well, how far do you get before all this shit withers away? So I followed him, about 8 hours later, ended up at his destination, and I just saw him there just packing what was left into boxes of wheat, mini wheats. That's all that's left. But on a, I'll leave you with one last thing. Actually, it's more of an announcement. I don't know if this is the right place for this. I kind of wish that my family would have been here for this. It's kind of a personal thing. I mean, I experimented a bit in college. Some of my friends growing up kind of knew my mannerisms. They kind of knew before I did, actually. This is kind of tough, but... here it goes. Oh shit, sorry, that's my time. My name's Brian Kvapil. Thank you.